Hi guys, it's Dr. Kelly Lipp here. I'm going to talk to you about how to brush your dog's teeth, even if that dog is a 90-pound golden doodle. So first thing you're going to need is obviously a toothbrush. For Teddy, we actually use a nail brush just because, as you can see, a regular size toothbrush just isn't going to be big enough for a dog his size. The one thing tricky about nail brushes, if you decide to try one, is that the bristles on them can be a little bit hard, so just make sure you pick out one with nice, soft bristles. For toothpaste, you want to make sure that you're getting one that is specific for dogs. We use CET toothpaste. It has a really nice vanilla mint flavor. What's important about dog toothpaste is that when you flip them over on the back, they should have something in them to help prevent gum or periodontal disease. This one has lactoperoxidase. Also, make sure there's no xylitol because that is toxic for dogs. And most dog toothpaste don't contain fluoride because dogs aren't very prone to cavities. And this is about how much toothpaste I use when I brush Teddy's teeth. Just like with humans, a little bit goes a long way. One tip I have is waiting for your dog to be in a sleepier mood before you attempt to brush his teeth. For us, that seems to help him just be a little bit more cooperative. But as you'll see, Teddy's never really that excited to have his teeth brushed.
No, he doesn't want to get his teeth clean.
As you can see, Teddy knows that if he lies down next to the coffee table, he's going to get his teeth brushed and he'll try to lie down elsewhere to get out of it. But just like with your kids, you've got to make them do it no matter how cute they are. I usually wear gloves when I brush Teddy's teeth. The dentist in me just mentally wants gloves when I'm in someone or something's mouth, but obviously you don't need to, just recommend washing your hands either before or after. Just like when you're brushing your child's teeth, you want to be positioned with them lying down with their head in your lap. This is going to give you the best view, the most control, and most closely simulate the position and ergonomics of when you brush your own teeth. If your patient is a bit uncooperative, you can have someone else at home help hold your pup. But if you're doing it alone, you can wrap your legs around the body like I'm doing here, and that's going to give you a lot more control. My feeling is that before you brush your dog's teeth, you should get a really good look in the mouth. If you know what's going on in there, you'll notice if something's changing. I usually just use my phone light to get a really good look at all of Teddy's teeth. Here's a picture of Teddy's teeth. In this view, you can see his gums and his molar right here. Teddy also has some staining. This staining isn't going to come off with a toothbrush and will have to be removed when he has a professional cleaning at the vet's office. In here, he has a deep pit in one of his molars. So I know anatomically, food and plaque are going to get trapped there easily and it's important to brush away. Thankfully, Teddy's a dog, so unlike humans, he doesn't have a westernized diet that's rich in refined carbohydrates. Because if this anatomical pit was in a person's mouth, it would definitely get a cavity if it didn't have a preventative dental sealant. If your patient doesn't want to open his mouth, or if your patient is like my dog and loves to chew on the toothbrush, you can use something to keep the mouth open. For Teddy, I like a rubber door stopper. I like a rubber door stopper for two reasons. The first one is that it's because it's rubber, so it's soft and it can't hurt or damage the teeth if Teddy decides to bite down. The second reason is because when you're all done, you can put it through the dishwasher. When I brush Teddy's teeth, first I put the larger end in the left side of his mouth, and then I brush the right side. And then, when I'm done, I switch. Another tip, if you don't want to use a door stopper, is I usually just take my non-dominant hand that's controlling Teddy's head, and I flip his lower lip over the chewing surfaces of his back molars. That way, when he bites down, he's biting on his lip in addition to my fingers, and it will keep him from closing all the way. Then when you brush the teeth, make sure you get all the surfaces. So the front teeth, the back teeth, the sides of the teeth, and the sides closest to the gum. You want to get a really good brushing around the gum lines, especially because most dogs are prone to periodontal disease or gum disease as they get older. And there you have it. Here's the final clean product, and now you can enjoy a few hours with the dog breath being nice and vanilla minty fresh. Don't forget you can throw the toothbrush along with a door stopper in the dishwasher so everything's nice and clean for next time.